Do you really have to go and study right now?
I have 2 tests on Thursday.
You worry too much. When's the last time you didn't get an A on a test?
I get A's because I worry. That's the whole point of worrying. And anyway.
Apartment was rented to one tenant, male, mid-20s, named Alan Brown. Looks like Brown was in the middle stages of putting together one or more explosive devices and got a little careless.
Or a lot. Any fatalities?
Only Brown. We've got one person in fair condition being treated for closed head trauma, another 3 people being treated for cuts from flying glass, minor scrapes, ringing ears. I guess it could have been worse.
Yeah, but without the mad bomber to answer questions, what was he up to? Did he have any accomplices? Where'd he get his materials?
I guess it's time to start talking to the neighbors.
I know it sounds cliche, but it's the truth. He was pretty much the quiet type as far as I could tell. No loud music, no wild parties. He'd be the perfect neighbor except for, you know, stuff blowing up.
So you were here when the explosion happened?
I was. Scared me half to death. I thought a truck had slammed into the building.
Was there ever anything about Mr. Brown that seemed strange or out of place?
Well, once you know that in the end something explodes, you think, oh yeah, I guess that's what that stuff was.
Stuff?
Yeah, a couple of times I saw him carrying around, like, lab stuff. You know, beakers, jars. But everybody else here is majoring in chem or biochem, so I just figured he was taking his classwork home.
Was there ever anything else?
Well, yeah. The smell coming out of that place sometimes was really bad. I used to live near a chemical plant when I was a kid, and some days, the smell of that place was like going back to my childhood.
If he'd have made just one phone call to campus police, we might actually have a live terrorist suspect we could be questioning instead of a body getting cold in a morgue.
We may have one answer.
What do you mean? Property, University Chem Lab 2360.
I'm Special Agent Williams. This is Special Agent Barber with the FBI. We're investigating the explosion that happened at the Belvedere Apartments last night, and we'd like to ask you a few questions.
You might want to talk to Dr. Ashton. He runs the lab. He'll be back anytime. We're just grad students.
We will, thanks. But we'd like to talk to you two.
I was here grading lab reports till 2 in the morning. I didn't
listen. Nobody here is a suspect. We already know who caused the explosion. We're just trying to connect some dots. There was a bottle of hydrogen peroxide at the scene with a label from this lab.
That guy.
What guy?
I knew that guy was weird.
Is this him?
Yeah, I saw him in here 3 or 4 days ago. It was around dinner time, so the place was mostly empty. I didn't recognize him, so I asked if he needed any help.
Hi, can I help you?
Hey. He said he was just picking up some stuff for Dr. Bridger.
What are you working
on? I asked what he was working on, and he just said plastic stuff, which was weird, but he was already walking away, and he knew Dr. Bridger, so... Concentrated hydrogen peroxide is pretty dangerous stuff.
Very simple, very strong oxidizer.
Used for everything from bleaching to rocket fuel.
Well, yeah. So you know, it's nothing to play with.
I bet that's the same container that went missing the other day. It was there on the shipping list. Someone definitely signed for it, but we needed it for our phenol process work, but we couldn't find it. So I borrowed it from next door, but I told them that I was taking it. It's not like it suddenly went missing.
Hang on. I got an email on Monday from this guy who said he was a student, but he didn't have an EDU address. Said he needed some advice on how to concentrate hydrogen peroxide. He told me the same thing he told you, that he was working with Dr. Bridger, and when I asked him what he needed it for, he just said propylene synthesis. But that's weird because Dr. B is pure theory. He would never do organic synthesis. When I told him I couldn't help, that was it. He never wrote back.
Well, he won't be writing anyone back anytime soon.
Well, he's not one of my senior students. I have hundreds of students every semester.
If I had him, he never did anything to stand out.
Did you know he was seen in the lab here recently? He used Dr. Bridger's name when one of your grad students talked to him.
You're kidding. Well, I can assure you there's no way John Bridger knew anything about this. It all just seems so crazy. I mean, it's not the sort of thing you'd expect to happen.
We'll talk to Dr. Bridger. But unfortunately, this type of thing happens more frequently than you think. Many universities don't have clear guidelines in place of suspicious activities that should trigger a call to the authorities. Here's some guidelines the FBI uses to identify suspicious behaviors in university laboratories. Sharing that information with your students will go a long way towards enhancing chemical security awareness on campus.
There are several things we can do to improve chemical security around the lab, like being aware of people trying to access the lab who don't have any business being here. Now, I know we work in a collaborative environment. We're going to see strange faces, but students need to know they may be asked what class or project they're with, and not to be shy about asking the same question of any student that they don't recognize. Locking up the lab when we're through for the day is a good idea also.
Yeah, we'll definitely do a better job keeping control of chemical inventory. If something's moved or missing, we'll say something. Even if we just think something might be missing.
It has to be that way with chemical and equipment orders, too. Like if something is ordered, but no one ever sees it arrive. Or if something arrives and no one knows who ordered it.
Yes, and any student needs to speak up when some unknown person asks for technical info, especially about hazardous materials or processes, whether it's email, phone call, internet chat, whatever.
I'm Bob Jones, Assistant Director of the FBI's Weapons of Mass Destruction Directorate. The video you just saw highlights the importance of the research and learning that takes place in an open academic environment. But it also highlights that these same environments may be opportune targets for criminals or terrorists looking for bomb-making chemicals or equipment. Everything you do to control your oversight of chemical dangers makes everyone safer, and your willingness to report suspicious activity to law enforcement is critical to securing the country against these threats.